In this video, we're going to have a look at 3D referencing. 3D referencing is basically just a way of linking worksheets together. I've got three worksheets with sales figures on for different areas of the country for 10 weeks, and at the bottom of each column, we've got a grand total for that area. So there's the total for Lancashire. If I switch to the Essex worksheet, there's the total for Essex. And if I switch to the Cumbria worksheet, there's the total for Cumbria. So what I want to do is be able to work with all these three sheets together on a consolidation worksheet called Total Sales. Here's my total sales figures, or it will be when I'm finished. What I want to do is bring in the Cumbria total here. Remember, that figure was in cell B12. So what I could do here is type this in, equals, and then I need the name of the worksheet that I want to pull that figure from, and it's the Cumbria worksheet. So I type in that name, Cumbria, and then I need an exclamation mark. And it's that exclamation mark that tells Excel that Cumbria is not a named cell, but actually the name of a worksheet. And then I just put the cell reference. It was B12. So what that is saying is equals whatever is in B12 on the Cumbria worksheet. Let's press the green button. And there's the figure, 64,000. Let's just check it. Yep, 64,000. And of course, if we make changes to any of these cells, the total updates on the normal worksheet, but it will also update on the consolidated worksheet. Yep, 60,000. So that's one way of doing it. We can type it in using that exclamation mark to define the worksheet, or we can use the point and click method. For this, we just use the equal sign and then select the worksheet that we want to get the figure from. This time is the Essex worksheet, and just click on the cell. It's the normal point and click method to build up a formula. This time you can see I've got my equal sign there. When I clicked on B12, it put in the worksheet name for me, Essex exclamation mark. And there's the figure for Essex. So you can see both methods, typing and point and click, actually give the same results. The formula looks the same. Now, because we're not actually doing any calculations, that's actually just called a link. We're linking that cell. And there's a third way of linking the cell, and that is by using paste link. So this time, if I go to the Lancashire worksheet, select the cell I want to work with, and you can do this on a range of cells. It doesn't just have to be one. Copy. That stores that information, that link, that cell reference on the clipboard. Go to our total sales worksheet, choose where we want that link to go, and then paste. We again get the paste options dialog box. We can click on there and do link cells. And there's the link. And you can see it's given me exactly the same type of formula, except this time it's converted the cell reference to an absolute cell reference. Now you must bear that in mind. That might not be appropriate depending on what you are doing. The other way of doing paste link, by the way, is edit, paste special, and we can get the paste link from there. It's exactly the same feature. So that is linking cells, and we can use that system of linking cells between the different worksheets to actually create formulas and functions. We'll do a formula first. I want to find out the total sales for these three areas. Now, of course, I could just do a sum in that cell there, and it would add up these figures, but I'm going to pretend that they're not there. In fact, let's get rid of them. So I can't use them. I want to pick up the numbers from these worksheets. Okay. So the first way is typing. Simple formula. Made more complex because we need the names of the worksheets. So I need equals Cumbria, exclamation mark, and then the cell reference, plus, next worksheet is Essex, exclamation mark, cell reference, plus, name of the worksheet. Make sure you get your typing accurate here. It won't work if you get any spelling mistakes. Exclamation mark, cell reference. Press the enter key, and there's the total of all those cells. I'm picking up B12 from each of the three worksheets, Cumbria, Essex, and Lancashire. Just remember, you need that exclamation mark to define the worksheet. And we can also do that using the point and click. So I can just do equals, select Cumbria, click, plus, Essex, click the cell that you want to work with, plus, Lancashire, select the cell that you want to work with, green tick, and there's our answer. So we can type or use point and click there to create a formula that consolidates that data from three or more, it doesn't have to be three, worksheets. Have a look at how that formula is. Remember about that exclamation mark. Of course, the benefit of doing that is that you don't have to always use the same cell. I could have Cumbria B12 plus Essex F27 plus Lancashire B56, and that would work just as well. But if your totals are all in the same cell, then we can use a 3D function. This is what we'll look at next, a 3D function. What function do we use to add up cells? Well, it's a sum function. And you'll know that to do that, we use equals sum and open our brackets. And we get that nice tool tips on at the bottom to help us, screen tips to help us work things out. But we know how to do a sum. The only difference here is that we're going to be using more than one sheet. So, what we have to do here is select the first worksheet, and for this to work, all your worksheets have to be side by side. Select the first worksheet, and you can see it's put Lancashire for me. Then the cell we want to work with, and it's put B12 for me. Now, this is the bit that's hard to remember. What we want to do is select the full range of worksheets. We've selected the first one, Lancashire B12. All we do now is point to the very last worksheet in the range of worksheets, hold down the Shift key, and then click to select. And you can see what's happened in my formula bar. Equals sum, Lancashire, colon, Cumbria. And then we've got that exclamation mark. So it means, and then the cell reference. So it means add up B12 from all of the worksheets between Lancashire and Cumbria. Let's make that happen. And there's our answer. Have a good look. Equals sum brackets, Lancashire colon Cumbria exclamation mark. That says all the worksheets between Lancashire and Cumbria, and then select B12, and that's what we're adding up. We don't just have to do that with sums. We can use a whole range of functions. Let's try with the average. Equals average, open brackets, select the first worksheet in the range, then select the cell, hold down your Shift key, select the last worksheet in the range, and finish off the function. And there's the average. So that's 3D referencing using sums and averages.